Hello everyone and welcome to Turning Works, where we're not turning because my lathe is not very well. So today's project is going to be taking apart the Record Power CL4 lathe and putting it back together again. Now I thought I'd do this video because I couldn't find one on YouTube unusually, so there was nothing on YouTube that could actually help me. So I've had to go old school and read something. Yeah, I know, it's mad, isn't it? I've actually had to read a manual, and I actually have it here. Right, it's made of paper, and I don't know if many people use these days, but look, it's an instruction manual. And the cool thing is about this instruction manual is it actually tells you what to do. Now, I've never done this before, so this is going to be a learning experience for me. But as I say, I couldn't find anything on YouTube, so I thought I'd put something on YouTube to try and help people out who might have this problem. So, let's take you over to the lathe, and we'll try and explain exactly what's going on. Okie dokie, hope you can see this. Now, what it is I've been turning a bowl with my son. This is not the bowl, although it could be a very small one. And there was this horrible grinding sort of sound. I didn't like it at all. And when I actually had the bowl on and lifted it up and down, can you hear that? I don't know if you can hear that. Hear that? Right, so that is a noise that we don't want, obviously. So the idea is to take this apart. Now excuse me while I move the camera. Okay, so first things first, safety. Right, take your plug out. Put in there. Right, plug is now down within the mess. Right, now press the on button. This will discharge any power that's left in this unit, because sometimes even if you've unplugged it and you push that, this will spin a quarter spin because of just the energy that's built up in here. Okay, so what we're going to do is this locking ring in here, we're going to put that in there, we're going to give it a tap with a mallet, and we're going to loosen this ring off completely. Okay, that's our first step. Take rubber off there, set to one side. Step two, undo the pressure adjustment lever. Okay, with the pressure adjustment lever, which adjusts the movement of the actual unit backwards and forwards, you can see, we pull it towards us. Gently move the pulley along, and there we go. That's all we can rest that back there now. So that's, we've got a lot of room, that's out of the way. Okay. With the spanner holding the spindle shaft on the two flat sides, we now undo this Allen bolt, sorry. So, and we take it off, washer and all. Now I'm putting all the parts in the bowl so you don't lose them. Okay, so having taken the washer and the Allen bolt out of the end, we're now going to undo this grub screw. Now there's actually two grub screws here, so you've got like a locking, that sort of locking nuts. So I'm just unscrewing the top one, and you want to take this right away out. Yeah. 20 gram screw there. We'll put that in our bowl. In the bottom of here is the actual grub screw that holds this pulley wheel onto the shaft. So we're gonna undo this. Surprisingly loose, that might have been what the problem was. You never know. So we don't need to take this all the way out. Just until that moves backwards and forwards. But you don't want to take that out, you want to leave it in there. There we go, lovely. So now we have to undo this locking ring. So the way we do that, we've got our brass rod and our mallet. Put that on the flat as best you can with most contact, and then hopefully okay, there we have that. Here's the scary bit. Right, so we now, oh, that's actually looser than I thought. It says you have to loosen this a bit. So that's loose anyway. Now what you have to do now is with your mallet and with your brass rod, you have to bang round the back. So basically, brass rod in centre and tap with a mallet. See that? Okay, mallet, copper rod on the spindle at the back. Aha! This is. Oh, that's quite cool. So if you're going to change the drive pulley, this is the point that you do that, because everything's loose there and you can get that out. Okay, this one's okay, so no problems there, but that to one side. Obviously remember to put it back in before you tighten everything up, because otherwise that might be a bit of a nightmare. We're trying to remember that at the end. So there we have push a spindle through the back bearing, and there we go. So back bearing comes out. Make sure that doesn't get any rubbish in it, so just covering it with some oily stuff. Put that in a bowl. Now get some. Now we should be able to pull spindle. There we go. So that is the spindle. That is the inside locking nut. And that is the pulley. So I'm going to give it a good clean up while we've got everything off, and I shall come back in a moment. So here's a spindle out of the headstock. So what we do now is you can undo the thread protector, that there, and you can now, there we go, that's what all the fuss is about. So there's the bronze bearing, and then we have the tapered end. So it's just down to cleaning everything up. You can inspect it as well. Let's make sure there's nothing got in there. No lumps. A couple of little marks in there, but hopefully it'll be okay. So there we go. Just clean up the bearing as well. I'm going to get all the muck out of this. You'll notice the holes at the top there. I believe that's for when the oil, obviously you've got the oil you've got the oil reservoir, and that sort of drips into these, which then oils the spindle. It all works lovely. So I'm just going to clean this lot up and we'll be back. So here we have all the bits disassembled and cleaned. There are a few things to note. Okay, so this is a drive pulley. You have the Allen bolt there. This is a pulley. Now you notice on this you have the flat edges where the spanner goes round to lock it. You also have this channel here, which is for the little scrub screw from here to lock into. You have the end where the back bearing goes. You have the thread. Okay, and you've got this bit here, which is obviously chamfered down, which fits into there, which has got a corresponding chamfer. So that fits in nice and snugly in there. Okay, what I've noticed when I dismounted this is the bearing, if you can see that, has got some sort of compression on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and get a new bearing, but in the meantime I'm going to put this back on. For now we're going to put this back on because I haven't got another bearing at the moment, but I'll look into getting another one. So I can replace it. So now all we've got to do is put it back on. Okay, so spindle into bearing, thread lock on, thread protector on. That line there lines up with this here. So, but before we go too far, let's put the locking nut on. Let's also get our spindle in there as well. Okay. Got to get our in there as well. Remember the belt, let's put that on now. If we can get it in there. Okay, belt's on. Okay, that's in there. Try a few light taps with me mallet. Right, there we go. So the back bearing is located nicely on the spindle. The belt's on, that's the right way round. So now we have to tighten up this ring here, which I'm not sure what I'll show you in a second. There's the ring, so tighten that up on there. Okay, as tight as you can with your hands. And it's back to the old rubber mallet and copper rod. And I'm going to try and tighten it up. So I could turn it, couldn't I? Silly me. Make it a bit easier. Right. Now we have to. So we've already just tightened up the internal locking ring. Now we're just going to give this a couple of taps clockwise just to snug it up, tighten it up a little bit. So rubber mallet, copper rod. Not moving anymore, so that's good enough. So now we have to line this screw up and this pulley with that pulley there. So we have to find the that little groove that I showed you earlier. Is there. Here we go. So I just held gentle pressure on this, turn this spindle, and it just popped into the groove. So before we tighten it up too much, we want to line this up with the other pulley. So line up this end here with the end of that, and then we're happy that that's pretty much the same. Let me tighten the internal grub screw up. I'm going to do it a little bit tighter than it was before, just in case. It did seem rather loose when I undid it. Alright, so not too tight. Right, okay, so now that's in there. Now we have to get the second grub screw, which acts as a locking nut, which basically stops the first nut from undoing. Coming loose, I wonder if we're getting straight would be helpful. Damn it. So get the other grub screw in like that. Once that's tight, there's no way that bottom grub screw can move. Tighten that up. I'm not straining too much when I'm tightening that up. Okay. So there we go. There's our spindle and pulley in there. Okay, so here's the Allen bolt and washer. Now the instructions say, so you hold the spindle obviously while you tighten this up. Instructions say finger tight, so that's finger tight, and then quarter turn. So see, that is at 3 o'clock, quarter turn. There we go, pretty much there. That's just, there we go, 6 o'clock. Rubber cap. There we go. Now we have to hold the motor unit, bring it towards us, lifting those pulleys like so. Belt over the first one. There we go. Now I always put this on the middle one because it the best sort of range of speeds. Okay, so that's in the middle one there. Okay, and then we'll just let it go back. Tighten up the pressure lever. Go, that's not going anywhere. So we have oil in here, 30W oil. So this turns not easily, quite stiffly. Plug. Now I've turned it right down just in case anything bad happens, which I hope it won't. So here we go. Low speed. You see the oil flinging out because I've over lubricated it. So this should run for about 5 minutes. Probably best not to put a bowl on there straight away. Just let it bed in for a while. About 5 minutes they recommend. So I'll come back in about 5 minutes. Okay, so I hope you found that that little video interesting or useful if you've got a CL4. Things to consider when taking apart one of these things. Keep everything in a bowl or a container. If you take it off this, put it in a bowl. Keep it safe because you don't want to lose anything. Number two is always read the instructions. Now you can get these instructions on a PDF form from a free Instructables website, so you can download that to your phone or whatever, so you've got it handy. Even though I've got a paper version, I've downloaded it as well onto my phone, so just can't find it. Now, another really, really important thing, this brass rod that comes with it. You might wonder what this brass rod is for when you get your lathe. I did, and I put this somewhere very, very safe. In fact, so safe it took me 2 days to find it. So you need this because you don't want to damage anything in there. So difficulties, I would say, getting the back bearing back on. It's all a little bit fiddly in there because you've got limited room and space, and you've only got sort of probably an inch and a half to get your back bearing on. So another important thing is to, when you're banging the spindle back in to the through here and to the back bearing, make sure you do like the instructions say, turn it quarter, bang, turn it another quarter, bang, turn it another quarter, bang, because otherwise you'll distort all the insides in there. Use 30W oil and read the instruction book again before you do anything. Always read the instructions. They're there for a reason. They're very useful and you should follow them word for word if you can. If not, then ask someone who's a bit more experienced than yourself on mechanics, that sort of thing. So yeah, quite a simple thing actually. It wasn't as anywhere near as difficult as I thought it would be. I think next time what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the actual motor apart, put that back, clean it, put that back together again so I can see how that works. The only thing wrong with this one is, well, I say wrong, the back bearing might need replacing, because when I took it off, it looks like the person who had it before me gave it a few wallops with, I don't think he used this, because this was unused. When I looked at it, it hadn't been used at all. So the person before me obviously had used something else and had dented the bearing bit, which might be part of the reason why it was grinding a little bit, but I'll look into getting a new one of those as well. But that's it for this session. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you found it interesting. Please like and subscribe. Got a few more projects coming up quite soon. And good luck. See you soon, guys. Take care.